Welcome to the show, my brother Yekeh Kolubah. I know he just went off. Representative Kolubah, welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you. Am I on?
There you are, Yekeh.
Okay, thank you. Look, you see, we need to respect the law. We shouldn't sit because we come on a platform because we want to use a platform for Joseph Baka to implore us. It's wrong. It's wrong. You can't look at somebody testing in the street and arrest it, you see, because the person work, the person needs to Napono, the person work with this person. This law that made put a back out on GSA was brought in by Joseph Baka and Ellen Gorman. They saw it. They brought it. And they knew that's the law. What the chief, the director of police brought like 10 cents. He brought it through the law. Now the law says. And they give it to him, they didn't steal it. We see you want to, you know, I spent some time in the police. When you say you're working on an asset team, you have to do your investigation and say, look, Yekeh work in government. Yekeh will assign this car. Where is this car? Do your investigation, go to the court and obtain search and seizures for the court. But you know, Farika, you cannot be working in the security sector. You come and sit on the national platform and misinform the people. Most of you people that are security people that are coming on the platform and misinforming people, no confidence in so many people. Because, for example, before DEA moved into somebody's house,
go back to Honorable Yekeh Kolubah. Honorable Kolubah, another 2 minutes.
So we go. Thank you. Let me say good evening to all of you on the show again. I had a call coming in. I have to change my phone. So, like I was saying, you know, we brought the government to respect. I believe in my mind, the previous government did not respect the law. When you want to arrest people's cars in the street, in fact, the asset recovery team is not police. They are not police people. To be arresting cars, say, go bring your car document. Are they on inspection? They are not. They are not. You want to do that kind of thing? You go to the court and get your search and seizure warrant. You go and search and seize. Did you do that? The court are nowhere wrong to say release the people's car. And we need to stop it. This is a national platform. We change George Weah government for the right thing to be gone. To be done. All the people on the asset thing, those are all people that came to wish hunt people. They are not in the interest of the country. That's my view. They are not in the interest of the country, and we don't believe them. Those people got a personal problem with past government. Like me, I have personal government. So I can never be independent in doing that kind of job. And listen to Farika. Farika, you work in the national security apparatus. Coming and sitting on that kind of big platform and telling the people, say, you know, the court shouldn't have released the people's cars, and you don't want to respect the law. In the first place, DA, you put moving into people's homes with all such warrant is wrong.
That's wrong.
Very, very, very wrong. Before you move into somebody's home, you must have such warrant. Let it be indicated that you're going to go search. You don't have to indicate what you're going to go search for. And everybody knows. But you put are moving to people's homes. We need people that will come out and challenge you people to the court. Don't see what the court will say. It's wrong. We need to respect the law. We have disrespected the law in this country. That's what we call the change. And the change must be the change. I want to appreciate
the court.
Thank you, Honorable Yekeh. And the court have not done nothing wrong. And that's your mama. He didn't stop it.
Hold on, let's do one at a time. Yekeh, Jumama will be coming on.
Thank you, you're right. I'm not with the ruling party, I'm in the opposition. So I don't want to pretend that I'm with the ruling party. I'm in the opposition now. So sometimes ANC group, sometimes you see me in the CDC group. But let me tell you something. People that are in government now, they not show their faces to the people to tell them, say, campaign or vote for this government. We put our face in there. So we're not sit and people that didn't come from anywhere support this the country. And I can safely say on this show, with the authority that we have formed a plaque. That money that is allocated for the asset recovery team, they will not get it. We will vote against it. If it will mean that the budget don't go, it will not go. As long as they have people on that team that want to pay debt, it will not work. Let the president take money from his budget and put it there. I will always speak the way I can speak. I'm not going to change it. So to sit here and tell you I will change it, it's not possible.
But you do believe asset recovery is necessary. You do believe in that. You
yes.
support that, don't you?
Okay. Yes. But the people are carrying the message. They are not the rightful people. They already got grudge. Look at what Gwonko said. He said, you know, park the car for the. You look at some of the private taxi. You pack it. Where's the evidence? Have you done your investigation? Do you have seizure document from the court to seize the poor property? They mentioned you paper that he bought a car from GSA. You still put the former director of police down for his car. It's a disrespect.
Okay, so, but,
it's a gross disrespect.
But Amber Kolubah, though, you.
We all know those taxes were being owned by Fina Bono. My say you know it. So we came with that mind. You're part all. Look, if I was Fina Bono, I would sue those people for a good bill of money. And the government will pay. Don't waste our time. We'll have a black. We will not let that money pass for the asset recovery until we can have people that got interest, not people that got a mind that we're going to go wish on.
Thank you, Mr. Kolubah. And we're going to go to Sis Glennie. Okay, can he respond?
Yeah, he can respond.
Okay. I want to say on the platform again, stand my statement. All of you.
Your statement is incorrect. Your statement is incorrect.
Give him a chance to respond. Glennie, give him a chance to speak, please.
All of you people on the show here, because you want to be on the show so government can give you a job. I can name plenty of people that have been on the show, and most of you here still seeking
that's,
for jobs.
No,
Abba, don't interrupt me. Yes, sir.
Like I said my statement, 90% of you people on the show here to look for job, and you people have been paid by Stanton. That's my statement. Yeah, we'll bring
well,
the evidence.
It's good that you said 90%. Because yeah. 90 plus 10 equals 100. That 10% that you are not talking about, I am in that 10%. I am not included.
No, you and are
Exactly.
So let me say this to you, Fadika. You know, during my days in the SOD, during my day in the police, we did a lot of wrong things. That was a LeBron post.
I'm glad you acknowledge it.
So can I go ahead now? That was a LeBron post. We change your and chat to the other country here because you have done wrong. Man, I said it came. The same old thing continue. Now we get into the government we brought. Let me tell you something, Stanton. There's a serious fight going on in all the ministry and agency. Because Fadi got fees within his cell, his name was called by the president, AB Commander, not his boss. Because the other man fee that his name was called by the president, AB Commander, look, letting a serious in-house fighting going on. Don't mind AB Commander saying that during the day. He's doing that, nothing going on. Those people will never work together until those people can know who is the boss. Not because Joseph Baka called your name on the national radio, then I've been hiring somebody. And at the truth, you don't want to say, the people will not achieve nothing because they're fighting, no understanding, and no good working relationship because everybody wants to be the boss. Because the thing they sat down on your show, Stanton, and you use Joseph Baga to get a job so they feel they're so powerful. It's wrong. Yeah, Fadika, our government was very rude. That was the country move us. So we want the right thing to be done.
You had one of the most dangerous forces. SOD put me on the bench before. You have a DA.
Thank you. Let me make it very clear. And thank God you brought up about going on an SOD 4 seat. So can you tell the people why I put you on an SOD 4 seat?
No
you
reason.
Tell the people.
Who are available. Somebody call you.
Because go ahead. Tell the people why I put you. Why I put you on
an SOD 4 seat. I'll give you the chance to explain it. Maybe you know.
No, you tell the people. So I'm going to tell the people now.
Yeah, tell it, Nigerian people, why you
because know. At that time you were phoning Barapa. You are a serious person that was taking real drugs. While real drugs. So can I talk?
Go ahead.
No, you call it issue now. I don't want to bring it up.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, you may proceed.
So I want you to tell the people that when I saw you do Barapa behind the old defense ministry, then when you were arrested, I took out your shirt and handcuffed you and put you on an SOD4C because I wanted you to change for other drugs.
Yeah, you know that is not true. I've never been associated with
you. But you tell me that I arrested you. So tell them why I arrested you.
That was your nature. I mean, I'm just trying to.
Yeah, you look now. You look better. If I'm not going to
have everybody that know me now. I want to use this opportunity to demand an apology from you for lying that you caught me in the ghetto. This is international media. People are listening all. As a friend and brother, I demand an apology from you, a public apology for misrepresenting the fact. And I take this with very, very seriously. I demand an apology from you, our lawmaker.
I respect you
in a public manner.
You're not joking. Can I talk now?
Yeah, okay, just say you are joking. Just say that.
Go ahead now.
Yeah, you can go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay, look. I maintain my statement. You boil up. I knew our secret. I wanted to be this, but you boil up. So what can I deny here? What do you want me to take back when you boil up?
The SOD was you. You are SOD commander.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, but the one that you see now is not true. I agree. You know, the one I'm talking about.
I agree. You brought our secret out. You know what secret between you and myself. You brought it out, so I can't deny it now. It's in the public. Thank you very much. You spoke well. But like I said, and I will always say in my statement, I'm not going to take my statement back. Because don't take, for example, Stanton, how many persons they have appointed from your show? Because 90% of the people feel that when you get on Stanton's show, they will get you jobs. So all of y'all run to this show here. And I'm maintaining my statement. When it comes to the budget, look, in the first place, we campaign that we're going to put the civil servant salary back to where it was. The president put the $30 million there for the civil servant salary to come back to state of course. No. But what he did was to reduce the civil servant salary. Took $9 million away from the civil servant salary. And put money to where all the government go to steal money. NSA. All the government, when they come, where they go to steal money to NSA. But let me tell you something today. We're not going to talk too much. We have a plaque that will resist most of the things in the budget. We know where the president has taken money from his budget and put money to places that he will go for. Well, I'm not going to say this on the platform, but the action will speak for itself. So if your team don't have interest in the project and how the country will be run, don't waste your time. I'm not schooled when it comes to budget, but I got somebody that working on it and gave me information that I trust 100%. So when it comes to the budget, I'm not going to say here what we have decided to do as a plaque. That particular plaque that will ensure that most of the things, most of the places they have the money that will not pass, the plaque is being formed already. And I'm not going to name the people on the plaque. So when it comes to the budget, that all I can say about it. I'm making that 90% you put on the show can have to look for a job. Because people on stand on show. They don't, how many people on your show not get a job?
None.
Center. Where Fadiga came from?
None.
Was that the name that people Fadiga was never on the show.
Hold on 1 minute. I'll say your second question, sir.
Thank you, Center.
Right. And take something that will pay back.
And then corruption again. Right. And then corruption again from the president's office. And then corruption again. Go ahead.
You know what? You're not going to put me in your politics. And you know better to put me in your politics. You know that?
Can you be clear when you say someone from the president office assisted you? Can you be clear?
Thank you.
So listen.
Calm yourself.
Shut. Mind you.
Indict yourself. So we need to use the law to do that. We need to use the law to do that. And that is what we expected of the asset recovery team to do the investigation and see if all the statements we made, if we can achieve. But can we do that? We're acting against her. We're wearing reflected jacket like Waterspoon bought for us as donation to the recovery team. Reflected jacket.
Thank you, Yekeh.
It looks just like me, though, just so you know.
I mean, you're ugly like your pal.
Right? You say you're on the opposition. You threaten you will go on the side of the opposition, Yekeh. What do you want from Joseph Yema Bracken? What you want from Unity? What they are doing that you don't like? Are you now friends? CDC, maybe you'll be one of the lead auditor. So let me say, let it get verse. But I'm concerned about you. Distance yourself from CDC. Thank God I said, though it's not on the show, because I don't want to wake up one morning and I hear that Yekeh left in his sleep. Please.
Thank you. So can I talk now?
Yeah, Yekeh. That was sure.
Let me be on record to say this. If CDC will kill me, I love it. And I know they can do. I have not talked to Ambassador Weah. I have not met Ambassador Weah, but we have to remain in the opposition to ensure that those things that we change Judge Weah for should not come back to where we're looking at. You said, you tell you what I want Joseph Ambassador Bakker to do, right? Let him sack Prince Mui Wef because they're not from the government. Let him sack all the family who have been appointed, the Yimane, then his sister's son. Let Jeremiah Kuhn sack his wife, sister that have been employed in government. This is not a family government. This is a government for the Liberian people. Let Prince Mwaden stop employing people to help ministry and other places that they will put them to go bring money back to them. This is not what we brought government for. We raise our left because we thought things were not fine with the Liberian people. Today, we see nothing being changed. Today, we see the Minister of State being a Minister of State to President-elect requesting money from other places. We see the Minister of State giving lawmakers 4,005 each. What did we change? Let President Boakai take won't quit them for an asset recovery team because their minds are fake to come and wish hunt people. Then we can be friends. The friendship does not work with them. The friendship that to be in the opposition to make sure that the right things are done. If CDC will kill me, let me die. But I'm in the opposition. If Joe, we are coming now, that's how I'll go to her. I will leave my heart now. But Joseph Boakai call me, I'm not safe to go there. But when Joe, we are coming now, I will go to him. If I wrap basketball to go, I know that I was safe. I will go to him to rehab. Not President Boakai. I'm not safe in here. Because they do not want people to talk. And we need to talk. We were in the butches. We were over back. Going from county to county. Ah, Joseph Boakai, the last time as the chairman on the show, Joseph Boakai gave me five that I had to run campaign for him. I got my bag then packing and stole there. I did it because I want the government to not make the Liberian people shame. Are we shame? Yes, we are shame. But I will not regret it. Ambassador Boakai will regret why he knew me, and he will regret why I voted and campaigned for him. So I trust the CDC, I trust any party in the opposition and Joseph Boakai. So here I'm working again like history. It can't happen no more. I'm in the opposition now.
Dodo, I'm done with my question. Thank you. I'm done with my question. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Yekeh. It seems Yekeh has a response to everything. But only with Yekeh, I'm going to say this to you, sir.
This is coming 1 minute.
Thank you.
Can I come in 1 minute?
Please? Yeah, I'll give you 30 seconds, sir. Go ahead.
Thank you. It's enough. Look, That is why we want President Buaka to respect the law when he was vice president. That they brought on how people can buy cars from GSA. He need to respect it. That is why we want President Buaka to respect the 10 new positions. Until that can be done, forget it. Don't waste your time. I will talk the way I can talk, and I will behave the way I can behave. I'm not going to change it for no reason. Let them stop haunting the 10 new people. There's a law. There's a reason why you can move them. Have you followed that process? You go take one letter and go get the Prince Mweden to go to what they play in the NASCAR to go put people in office. That Prince Mweden job to go put people in office. Eh? President Buaka disrespected himself. That's why he got the disrespect in return from Mrs. Yekeh. So he fired the woman illegally, and he need to stop it.
Thank you, sir.
To Honorable Yekeh Kolubah, I would just like to say, regardless of what you think, you're one of our favorite lawmakers. We just
want you. I'm a witness.
I respect.
I go to woman and I eat.
You are witness, Yekeh? You are witness?
You are witness.
You are witness of who?
Yeah. ABM, I said, I ate to your holiday food. I know who cooked the food.
Yeah.
Yo. Can I speak to Honorable Yekeh?
Yeah, go ahead. You listen and say,
I wasn't on the show and I heard you were saying something, but I go out to do something. So I want to ask my Lupa candidate man, what happened? What ended your mama did?
You gotta tell me. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Then I'm grateful that you didn't say anything when I wasn't on the show. But I like to say to you, Yekeh, now you know what it is. I've always admired you over the years because you spoke on behalf of the common people. And that's what I stand for. So I've always followed your word. And I've always spoken on behalf of you. I didn't know you. I have not met you in person before. I hope I can meet you one day. But
so let me appreciate you for keeping Fago in your basement for the longest after the pulling outside. You did well for him. At least you're not sleeping in the old folks home. You kept him to your basement. You know you did well for him with all the thing he talked here, all the money he made here on President Dr. Weah. He still ended up being in your basement. And I want to appreciate you for that.
Fago was never in my basement, though. He was never in my basement.
He will never agree to anything. He will never agree to anything. So can I close now?
But Fadiga, why you quiet? I mean,
You bring it all again? I'm bringing it up. Yeah, I used to save money every day so you can be ready for us. And I still believe you. I used to save money to prepare for us. I believe you and I want you to keep talking. Honestly, but I will tell you this. What survived during the Supreme
Court? Yeah. Let me ask you a question, Yekeh. Please help me understand. Are you a seditioner now? Or no, you just supporting the agenda for now?
So, I do not belong in a political party. I'm a member of the opposition. And CDC is in the opposition.
Okay.
So have I made that clear? I sell it on the CDC's ground. But why everybody get on my going to the
you CDC? You are not.
When you were there before, you stand on. You were married with CDC. Now today you're distancing yourself.
This guy.
I was engaged. I wasn't married. I was engaged to CDC.
Okay, you were engaged. So what is wrong that you saw that I'm going to see for myself? CDC don't want to
kill me. You're not even part of it. Why are you coming?
You see exactly what I was saying, Yekeh. When Amy was on the show, she wasn't talking like this.
No, he can make me fancy.
Let me say, I appreciate
you put on the show. People in the CDC, apart from our political differences, cannot do anything to me. They do not have any interest in harming me with our political differences. It was because of my stand. It was because of my political side that we were behaving the way we were behaving. So we want to encourage President Boakai to take control of his government. He's not in charge. As long as you leave people like Prince Muhyiddin in charge, employing their family people, is that wrong for liberal to work? But things that will frown on that time, they shouldn't exist in the government we brought. We see people saying, oh yeah, but you don't want me to vote for him. So I'm gonna see the truth, I'm gonna say it. No laws came in being when President Boakai was vice president. Why he didn't say anything about it? It was passed on his watch. But today, all the laws have been disrespected. And we did not bring the government for wish hunt. We see people coming to wish hunt. We are also calling on the national security. We know that Buju Ben Keita has called the people. He said, look, the coupon case is very serious. We don't want to get into it because we bring disgrace to the government. And Stanton, you know that coupon case is a serious case. It's bringing the presidency to public ridicule. I took the case to the police. And the police have resolved not to go into my case. But going forward from Monday, I'm going to address my issue exactly to President Boakai. Because it's on his watch. We voted for him. We not voted for Buju Ben Keita. That was in one OG. I don't have food to eat. But today he wants to take charge of what we suffer for. We didn't bring the government for that. We brought the government for everybody to have equal justice. And as long as they can't prove me wrong, like other people say, I want the World Trade Center and face the coupon. Stanton, you got to call on the government to prove me wrong. If not, next week will be too worse. I will go too radical on President Boakai next week because he's in charge. He's the one we voted for. He's the one I campaigned for. Not for the things to happen. I remember during the CDC time, during President Dada Joy Weata, I took my case to the police. They not a person cry it, even down to the court. Those are things that we saw, we say, but then you have to be one-time president. What thing have changed? Nothing. Wish hunt. We wanted to stop it. Don't arrest people's car. The asset recovery team are not police supposed to do a vehicle inspection. It's wrong. And let me appreciate the court for telling them to give the people their property back and encouraging all the people that the property was seized to go and sue them for damages, the embarrassment it caused for them. Not test the court process. Honor President Boakai. Let me say thank you, President Boakai. Please respect the laws. Let the laws be respected. We sat down here, we say the laws are not respected. George, we are Mago. George, we are go. George, we are go. Today, President Dr. George, we are a city. Nothing has changed. President Boakai, you get me to contend with for 6 years. Let me say thank you and God bless everybody. Well, let's be on your show. Thank you.
Thank you, Yekeh. Representative District Number 10, thank you very much. It's always good to have you and want to appreciate your time, guys. Let's wrap this thing up.